I don't know how long this video is. You might want to check and then adjust your living conditions accordingly. So, digital audio players, why bother? Phones exist. Here's my phone. I can unlock my phone. I can go out on my phone. I could load up. Actually, I have the FUBAR actual app. FUBAR makes an app. You can go here and you can look by composer and shuffle tracks. And oh my God, look at all these options that you have to search. And it's great. And you could put Spotify on this too. And your digital audio players are actually making a comeback now. Because phones, they are a cure-all. But it's annoying to have to take your phone out, listen to music, and then take your phone out, text, and just phone call. People just want to just disconnect from their phone and have a digital audio player. So these are six players, and I'll tell you how these arrived. Fiio sent me the X1 and the M3. I bought both Cowons, the Pleno D and the M2. Hifiman sent me the Mega Mini, and the guy, Bill, who sent me all the expensive stuff like the Hifiman HE1000s, let me borrow his Astelin Kern 240. So these are either sent to me by companies, bought myself, or borrowed. And the best part about all that is I don't give a shit. Okay. I just went over a long period of making bullet points and just, you know, looking up facts and battery life and then deciding what the power levels were. The last four, all these played on the 2000Xs. I've got the closed ether flows here for my hard test. I'm tired of pulling out the T50RPs as like the end all, because those are just, no one's walking around with those as a portable solution. Instead, let's go with the ether flow Cs, because that makes much more sense. I have my M40s over here, and I've got the 600s, which are sort of like the, probably the hardest thing you would ever want to drive portably, middle ground. Chewbacca's gonna coo now. I put them down in random order on the page, color coded, because I loved like preschool, and I guess I loved colors. We'll start with the M3, and I'll try to make these like very contained so I could put a time link in the description. Like right now, I'm gonna start talking about the M3, the Fiio M3. Here's the Fiio M3. Look at it, isn't it pretty? They're all fully charged. Some of them don't have SD cards. I just didn't have enough to run them all. I was sharing. But luckily, the Fiio M3 has 8 gigs of internal memory. So let's turn it on. And I'm going to turn every one of them on so you could see how long that takes. And we're in. And we're ready to play. I need an easy to mess with set of headphones for this. Like that cable. That's a Relic cable. This is their second one they've sent me there. Oh, they're so nice. Lower the volume. Get a little volume display. Ooh, scrolly, scrolly, scrolly. Pause. Pause. It's fading out the pause. So, I'll just go over the things that we know. 8 gigs of internal memory with a micro SD card slot. They all are micro SD card slots. They're all micro USBs. So, I don't have to bring that up ever again. This will handle a 64 gig external and has 8 gigs of internal. Battery life, 24 hours of playback. That's pretty good. Wait till I get to some of these others in this list, and you're gonna be like, that's pretty good. In fact, that's really good considering the size of it. And it is losably small. How's that? It comes with a little lanyard. I have the boxes with all their accessories in them. I was gonna have them all laid out, and it's just too much work. They all have, this actually came with earbuds too, that I just took out and went and dropped them. So you got a lanyard, you got a couple things, you might even get a cock ring because it's Fiio and they love to include those. Things I wrote, crossfade. They have a really nice crossfade function. So you can go from one song to the next. So if I, it's quick. It's like down, up, down, up. And this is important to note because there are some others in the future. Fiio again, that are not usable, basically. Just bashing these together because they're M40s and they're great. Screen off navigation. Now, these bullet points, by the way, are positive or negative. I don't remember. I just put them down. I should have done different colors if I wanted to be real specific. So the crossfade is excellent. It does a good crossfade. That's a thing, right? It's a bullet point. It's the cheapest unit, in case you haven't guessed. This is like $50. And the price is going to come in a little bit more and more as we go along. And the value and worth of units. So, it's got a good crossgrade. You can do screen off navigation. And again, that has to come up because later in the list, things start to suck. So you turn it on, you get the screen, you want to navigate, you hit the power button, you turn it back on, listen to Django, you want to go to the list, you hit that. You get to choose between, I think if you want to look up the actual playlists, individual songs, artists, albums, and then folder search. Which I usually do folder search because I'm an obsessive person that does everything by file name. But you know, no touch screen. So you have to sort of scroll down or have things in very organized folders if you want to get to them fast. And you just hit go. It's volume up, volume down. It goes from 0 to 60 and wait for that to disappear. And you can hit next track is there. This is all one solid panel, which is just shiny black plastic, so you're gonna do this. Oh, here, look, I got a new player. Oh, you wanna see it too? All right, gotta clean it every 3 seconds. Yeah, and here's your menu button, so here's the play screen, and I'm sure we do album art, but I don't have any album art attached to these files or in the folders, so it's just showing a generic spinning vinyl record player. Even though vinyl's not superior, we know this. You hold it down, it brings you to the secondary menu. So you get to choose shuffle or straight through. You could add to a playlist. You could go to the EQ. EQ with custom. So you get off rock, blues, metal, blah, 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 blah. At the bottom, you get custom. You go in there. And you got a 5-band EQ that you can adjust. And that's nice of them to offer it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's weird. Because it shows 0, negative 2, negative 4, negative 6. And there's only 5 clicks to get to negative 6. So it's like 1 3/4. It's like 1.5 decibels per click. I don't know. It's fine. I'm okay with that. Hit back. We have the settings at the very bottom. I'm going to go through. You can also delete the song that's playing currently right there. Go to the information of the song that's currently playing right there. Settings. Resume position. Fade in, fade out. Again, it's very good on this unit. You could set the max volume. I guess if you give this to your kids, which are $50. Kids first MP3 player or FLAC player. Oh, by the way. These will all do MP3s. They'll all do FLAC. Some will do ALAC. You got a dot around. The only one that does DSD, your heavy duty audio, is going to be the Aslan Kern over there. But again, I'm not sold on super high res. Screen fell asleep. For portable, at least. So you got max volume. You set the default volume to memory, or you can set it to an individual number. You could adjust the balance. You could display the cover or nothing. English, screen timeouts, brightness, idle timer, sleep timer, theme. It's got blue or white. I have it in blue. You have the screen off button response. So you could either have, when the screen is off, these don't work either, which is like a super lock. But if you're going to have it in your pocket or something, you want to be able to change the track. Storage formatting, firmware update, blah, 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 blah. We're done. That's it. This is a basic unit. But as basic as it is, it functions. It has a sound. All of these sound better than my phone. All of them. And I have a Moto X Gen 2 with the bamboo back. Or is that teak? Might be teak, because I know boats have it made of teak. And compare, my phone is not the greatest phone. It's not the worst phone. But all of these, including this $50 one, sound better than my phone. They get louder than my phone, clearer than my phone, even with FLAC. Through the FUBAR app. And that's why. Everyone's talking about that LG V20 or whatever the hell that is. And I'm not going to start reviewing phones because of their audio. How the hell would you even do that? ZMF for the win. Okay. So no touchscreen. Which, give or take, I mean, it's a little tiny thing. You've got a touchscreen, it'd be too crowded. It's got a good up, down, left, right set of buttons. Here's your lock on the side, which does lock out everything, I believe. Yeah, now everything's locked out. Micro SD card slot, micro USB slot, your 3.5mm on the bottom. It has meh pocket feel. We're going to talk about this a lot for this whole hour-long video, probably hour-long video. Pocket feel is when you take this player, well, unlike your phone, if you're on your phone and you want to change songs, you either need to have the thing on your actual headphone that you could hit next track, or you've got to pull it out of your pocket, wake it up, hit next track, shut your screen off, and put it back in your pocket. So one of the points of having a portable DAP, digital audio player, is that you can deal with it without taking it out. So this has, I mean, you could do it. It's off, and if as long as you know where the screen is, no matter if it's upside down or right side up, you know that, you know that, that's next track, and pause can happen. It's all right for pocket feel. It also has a slight pop between song changes, and I'm not sure if that's just from the fading or if it'll do it, you know, full, but every once in a while I'll hear like a little, it'll just stop, and then the next one will start. Not a big deal. And again, 24-hour battery life. So, should we move over? Let's move over. If I unplug it, let me just make sure something's on. If I unplug it, yeah, she pauses. This is another important feature. When you unplug it and she pauses, that means that the thing is waiting now. It's going to say, oh, nothing's happening. In 5 minutes, I'm going to shut off. And the reason that's important is because some of these other ones, when you unplug it, nothing happens, and then they just run until the battery dies, and you don't know it, and you have a dead player the next day. Skip to the other Fiio, or go across, or down. We're going to play. It really, it's going to be a pain in the ass to do this any way I do it. So let's just go to this one. Now, this is an Astle & Kern player, and it's expensive, and I'm not going to immediately come out and tell you how much this 240 costs. Let's just look at it for a second. Carbon fiber in the ass. It's got three buttons. Pause, play, next track, last track. Or actually, it's backwards from how I want it to be. This is next track and this is last track. Here's your micro SD card slot, which actually has just a dummy in it. Which I should demonstrate what this does because it's hilarious. Here. I don't know what this is going to do. But every time I try to pop one of these out with a card in it, it just does this. Hold on. Yeah, that went to like here and landed there. And it'll do that with cards too. And it scared the shit out of me the first day because a 128 gig card just disappeared into the ether. Okay, you're being a dick now. This is backwards. Oh, it is backwards because it's a... Whatever, the point is the card slot is like a comedy sketch waiting to happen where it'll just shoot whatever you try to take out of it into the stratosphere. I'm glad that actually worked on camera. The bottom, you've got just a standard micro SD slot. Here you've got a knob. It's got a decent click to it. It also feels a little loose, and that doesn't matter. And it looks like it should have a button, but it doesn't. And up here you've got power and then two outputs. Regular headphone out, which is what we're going to use. Or if you want to take your balanced outputs on the go, and I have... Here's the 2.5mm four pole that you would plug into that. And then if you have a normal balanced headphone, you have to have the adapter. And then you could take your crazy balanced headphones out for a walk. You know, while you're walking your dog and cleaning up poo in the middle of the night. Now what this basically is, I'm going to turn it on now, and again, I'm turning it on from an off position, is an Android device. Is it going to come on? It just doesn't like me anymore, and it's just never going to come on. All right, there you go, a little A. So let's see how long this takes to start. Now, turning this on and off is going to be a big thing if you buy it, because the battery life on this is the worst of the group, of all of them. Remember that was 24? This is less than 10. I've seen several reports of 8 to 9 hours being maximum. And for the cost, which again, I don't want to say the cost. I don't want to bring it up. You know, I want you to look at this and go, oh, carbon fiber, ooh, that metal, ooh, sharp edges. I want you to just look at it. It's why it's in a shootout with six other players, because I'm going to ignore cost. These are all basically media players. They're all portable music players, portable everything. And I'm just going to shoot them out as that, regardless of cost. This one is the cheapest. Just keep that in mind. This one is the most expensive. Just keep that in mind. So you get up with this menu, and you get songs, albums, artists, genres, playlist, folders, and it is a touchscreen. There is a store, and there is a CD library. I can't seem to get this screen clean. So here's CD library. Now, there, Astle & Kern sells a dock, which the owner of this bought, that is an Astle & Kern CD loader, and you just pop your CDs in, hit go, and it puts them on the unit, downloads all the shit for you, names all the files. It's pretty convenient. Most of us, the younger generation, are not going to need that. We either have it or we don't give a shit. And I've seen people's libraries. So let's go to songs. It loads over. You got a nice scroll here. You got a pull down scroll here. It'll actually change the font size. Like this says Prototype Outcast, and that says Puckett, Gary, and the Union Get, and it makes the font smaller so that it fits better on the screen. This is something that only like a high power Android device can do. Let's look at what I've got. Touchscreen HD. Yeah, it's ridiculous. It's a ridiculously high definition screen. I'm looking at the letter Q there, and it's a circle, and you know, any other of these players, that would be a, I can't tell what resolution this is, but it's a lot. It's basically like perfect. Eminem's Rap God. Did I hit play on that? There you go, it's playing. Oh, I did something too far, back. So here's the basic play screen. You get a seek bar right there. You gotta hit the information, it'll pop up very tiny. This is, again, because the screen is so high res, it can just use like size 2 font for all this. You get that, which is lyrics or empty, and then you have this button, which adds the playlist, which there's only 3 playlists. So I'm not gonna mess with that. Are those lights affecting this really poorly? I'm having a hard time judging. And then you can either skip track here. I should put these on now for a second. So I feel better when things are actually playing. Check the volume. Oh, it's set to balance out. Okay. So now it's playing Badfinger, and now it's playing Rod Stewart, or Stewart, Rod, which is sort of funny when you think about it. Touchscreen balanced out. Volume fuckery. Fuckery. So here's the volume control, right? Turn this knob. All this knob does, and this is a complete waste of an input, is volume. So you turn it and you get to adjust the volume. But as soon as you enable that, you can then just scroll up and down on the screen, which is way more convenient than rotating the volume knob constantly. And then there's the fact that, like, I could run harder to drive headphones, like my 600s, at full tilt. The power on this, on the normal out, not the balanced out, power on this one, I'm going to call as a 7 out of 10. 10 not being like, 10 is perfect, it'll do everything. This is a 7. It's a little baby unit. It does anything portably designed, hi-fi mins, the M40s, the 2000Xs, anything with low power requirements, it does just fine. These monsters and these, just a little lacking, so it's a 7. This, much more expensive unit, is an 8 out of the standard 3.5mm. Out of the balance, and for some reason balance is more power, and I'm sure some electrical engineer could explain that to me in the comments. Out of the balanced, it pushes about 9. About high as you'd ever need to go. But the volume fuckery, quote unquote, is because I'm talking to you right now with the volume at 70 out of 150, which is half. 75, let's go to the actual 75. And it feels like the volume should be at 10. It's barely singing. Here, I'll. Can we do this like this with these as ear speakers? So let's turn it up and let's. See, like, up here is all that matters in the volume. Down here, like, way down here, this is inaudible. There's no high and low gain. So your low gain is literally just play it down here. And I don't have any, like, super crazy sensitive IEMs that I could put on here and say, oh, well, obviously, now it works between 20 and 70, and then you put bigger. So it's just, you know, you turn it, And you could either do that all day or you could just drag it. So basically this would just be a button that goes volume control now, and then you do that and you touch to make it go away. So, works. I think it's a little bit too exponential. I think it should have a high-low volume switch somewhere in there. Knob don't nav. So let's navigate to a song. We hit the play this button here. Okay, so I could scroll this like this. I could touch it. It's a big, long scroll bar. And I want to turn this to, if I could turn this and make it navigate, that, no, it doesn't. It just is volume all the time. So, okay, get out of the volume. So now you're scrolling, and it's not going anywhere, because this player has like 4,000 songs on it. On the internal. Oh, by the way, internal memory, 256 gig. So at least they're giving you something for your money. And the external memory that you could add on is another 128 gig. So you could have a total of 384 gigs, which is a lot. But there's some others here that don't, you know, that... It's a lot, but it's not like a terabyte. This isn't a terabyte. So that only does volume, and that's a complete waste of a knob. A navigation. Just be cool. Just get on here like, oh, I'm going to scroll here. Nope, you got to do this. You got to mess your screen up. Okay. Put something else on. Elvis Presley. Now I have to go out of this list to go back to the now playing. And I can pause it. And I can play it. Here's the side buttons. You ready? Pause, play. Next track is down. Last track is up. And that's all these buttons do. I mean, if you hold them, we got a little bit of a skip. 30 seconds, 40 seconds, 50 seconds. It's not great. Let's go back to the home screen. Now let's pull this down. Ready? Does that look familiar? Oh, it looks like a phone. So here you get to choose Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, phone lock, shuffle, track repeat, whether it's loop one song or loop all songs. I believe that's gapless playback is the G. The EQ on this, do I get there yet? Am I ready yet? Oh, will pull Wi-Fi. I'm up to will pull Wi-Fi. So let's go out and go to that. No, that's the homepage again. Hold on. I've been using this thing for weeks. I should know how to use it. Should. Here, up here, AK Connect. So here's my device, which is what we're using, or you slide that over, and all of a sudden, boom, it has Wi-Fi devices, which the only Wi-Fi device in this apartment is my Sonos amp. So I click that, it shows me attributes, music shares, cues, blah, 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 blah. I go to my cues, queue instances, there are no files, there's something in here, hold on, I gotta find it. Music shares. And this computer doesn't exist anymore because it was my old computer before I rebuilt it. But here is my FLAC library on my other computer. It knows it. It knows all my folders and files. And if it still existed, it could literally play from the Wi-Fi. That's cool. That's cool. That is a cool thing. I gotta admit that's cool. What else do we got? Because I don't have a Sonos up now. So there. The other option is there are apps. And I know what you're saying. Well, does that mean that this portable player will play Spotify? You wish. And really, you do wish, but it won't. It won't do it. Get me the fuck out of here. Okay. Get me out of here. Mr. Wizard, get me out of here. Out of AK Connect. Maybe just go to the playlist. Okay, here you go. Where are my apps, bro? I need some apps, dog. What's app, dog? Is it some weird bolt? Okay, we're getting to the part of this ANK review that it's like, just work. Everything's very smooth. Everything's very pretty. Look at it go. Okay, we could search the server. Server selection doesn't support the search function. That's great. Balanced output is enabled? No, it should be off. Here is an option for... Yes. I have to switch. I have to physically move over and say, give me this device. Now we go back. Wow. I'm having a goddamn seizure. Here's settings. Let's go to settings. So just like your Android device, you got Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, AK Connect, which I can't get the fuck out of. The equalizer, gapless playback, line out. This will do line out. If you wanted to, it'll do a fixed line out. You have balanced out, you could turn on and off. You could adjust the balance, CD ripping, how that works. Brightness of the screen, which I have set to 4, it'll go, it doesn't actually get real bright. It just gets brighter. That's nice. Theme 2, which is dark. Date and time, the device name, English, keyboard, power, downloads, blah, 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 blah. Update system default settings. I'm not going to set anything back to default. Okay. Sonos Connect amp. All right, now we're finally back. Songs, albums, artists, genres, plays, folders. Let's go to folder. Internal storage. If I had a card, it would say something else. Loading. Here are the internal storage that the device came with. And you navigate it just like you would. You know, let's do Ad Libs, The Boys from New York, WMA. It's playing. How does it sound? Well, I know these are only M40s, but... And this is a terrible song for judging sound quality. But of the 6 players here, this sounds probably the best. By a slight margin. Not by a massive, I've never heard music in my life before, and this... is now Nirvana, not the band Nirvana, but like audio Nirvana. But it's definitely got a little more separation. It better for the cost. It better. It fucking better. It better. But, you know, it's a price to performance thing, and frankly, bounce his head. CEO's bounce his head. What else we got? Apps? I wanted to find the apps, goddammit. Internal storage folder, no. Store, go to the store. Here are the 3 apps, either that this has installed or that exists at all. I tried to do some research. Spotify is not available. So, okay, what is available? Tidal is available. I don't have a Tidal subscription anymore because I dropped that shit like it was hot after I realized I had it for a year and a half and paid over $300 to listen to it almost never. Spotify, I'm using all the time because the playlists are better and people use it and people link me things and I can listen to it in my bathroom. So you get Tidal, you get Qobuz, Q-O-B-U-Z, which when I press it, says to me, sorry, Qobuz isn't available in this country, because I'm in America, and Groovers Plus, which I'm like, oh, what the hell is that? And you open it, and it does actually open. And then it tries to sell you music in Korean, or Taiwanese, or I don't know the languages. There's a lot of circles. Thailand? I know it's not Japanese, but it's definitely trying to sell me whatever language this stuff is in. It's by. It's by me in DST. So it's... No. It's a no. 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 Please leave. Get me out of this. Please. Yeah. Get me the hell out of the store. Songs, scroll through the song. It's got the basic layout for how you search music, but it's only touchscreen. I wish there was a physicality to it. We're going to get to the X1 that has an actual rotating thing, but you know, it's all right. It does sound really good. Crazy EQ. Oh, good. I get to play with that now. Pull this down. Hold on EQ. You ready for this? I've never in my life seen something like this. So... It's labeled bullshit, which I'm sure he did. Which will shut it off, turn it on. 30, 45, 60, 90, 125, 180, 250, 360, 5, 710, 1000, 1400, 2, 4, 7. I don't know how many bands it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 band EQ, right? So it's a 20 band EQ, which is already crazy. Then you pick the one you want to deal with, and then down here you can scroll to tenths of a decibel for everything. So this is 45 hertz. I want to bring that up 0.9 dB all the way up to, I think, 5. It's not a very large swing, but oh my god, the accurate. That's room correction software doesn't have fucking EQs that insane. You can do that for every one of them. I just want 1.9 there. This is for someone who fiddles. If you're spending as much as you are on this player and putting music on it and going, no, I know better than everything. Let's fix this. Fuck, man. They got you. They have got you. Sir Psycho Sexy from the Red Hot Chili Peppers. Let's swap headphones. As much as I love the 40s, let's do 2000 X's. Because these are easy to drive. These are like 32 ohm. Unplug it, it detects and pauses it. So here we are. Now these are the easiest to drive headphones I have out. And right now, I'm at 115 volume. Out of 150, and if I took it there, it's loud, you could hear it. But it's like, and it gets away, and then at like 90 is like background music, and I could still make out what it is at like 50. But it's so quiet. And again, I'm not using that to control it, because it's this is a thing. All right. Sound quality is great, though. Sound quality is great. Worst battery life. Which begs the question of, okay, you spent that sum of money, which is written there, if you could read it. Can you read how much it says? It's that sum of money on this. It lasts less than 10 hours. It's okay for navigation. I mean, because really when we're talking about these players and what good they are, is they should be super easy to navigate. Just to change tracks. You could change track with a button, it's fine. You want to navigate with the actual thing to get to a specific song. Quiet phone. It should be that easy. And this one just isn't easy enough for what it is. Does sound really good though? Sound 10 times better than this? I don't think it does. But it sounds really good. It sounds really good. It's too expensive. It's hot, by the way. I'm just sitting here playing it, and it's hot. And do you want to shut down? And I'm going to say, okay. Astle and Kern, you can sleep now. I kind of want to do the two koans, one after the other. So let's go to the middle child. No. Yes. All right, the X1, because we already did the M3. This is probably the one that... Before this whole shootout started, I was just gonna say, here it is, it wins. Just buy the X1. Let's turn it on. Is it gonna say something silly? Born for music and happy. That one says it too, but it says it real fast. Welcome, born for music and happy. No internal memory, none to speak of, but the card slot in the bottom. And it is conflicting reports, because Fiio itself on the thing says 256 gig it'll support. And then one of the people who was commenting said, no, it only does 128. So I'm going to go with what Fiio said. I don't have a 256 card here, but since I'm keeping this, and I am in the future getting the X5 to review from them, it hasn't arrived yet. It's literally a slow boat from China. But I may want to try with a 256 and get... It'll be like 2/3 of my music library in FLAC on there, which sucks. Because that means 1/3 of my music library has to just not show up. Or I have to convert it to MP3, and that's... I don't mind for portable if I'm just wandering around in my car or something. So no internal memory. You get 256 external. Right in here, I've got, I think, a 64. It comes with its own case, which I'm going to take off now. Comes with a lot of accessories, actually, and I should open the box up for this. Mostly because I don't remember what it comes with. I just remember it comes with a lot of accessories. Get out of here, you bitch. Fiio box. What is that? Is that serious? Why would they do that? Maybe it doesn't come with any accessories and I'm just hallucinating. Oh, does it come with a screen protector? Oh, it does come with a screen protector. Two screen protectors. And the case, and maybe that's it. All right. Forget it. Forget I said anything. Point is, it's really smooth, nice feeling, you know, bar. It's like a used bar of soap. Not a new bar of soap. It's like a used bar of soap, the good kind. But if you want to protect that, it comes with mostly a condom. That covers everything except for the buttons. The top doesn't matter. The side over here doesn't matter. The bottom is where everything happens. So you can just go pop, 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 pop. And then, you know, you're protected. Excellent. Battery life on this. This one, this Fiio, which I could place inside its little thing, 24-hour battery life. The Aslan Kern player, which costs less than 10-hour battery life. The Fiio X1, which is only $100, which is double the cost of this and a lot less than this, 10-hour battery life. Now, I'm a stickler. When we get to the Cowons, you'll understand why I bought those and these had to be sent to me. So 10 hours isn't terrible. I mean, it's not a whole day though, it's not a full day. If you literally say, I'm gonna leave today and I'm gonna go do things for 11 hours and come back, your player's gonna die somewhere along the line. So you have to plug it in. But, see, I can't even say this has the most options because this, well, this is the most weird shit. This does have the most options. Where's my plug? Make plug go. That was going. Whoa, volume. All right. Thank you, Lindsay, and I could control it with that. I could pause it. I think I could pause it. No, yes, pause, okay. I'll quickly run through these and then I'm just gonna stare at it and try to remember everything that I know about this player because it's really hard. Because this does so much shit. The first thing I wrote down, probably because it's the most important bullet point, is car mode USB. So you plug power into the bottom of this, micro USB, and if it's in your car, you set it to car mode USB. And what that'll do is when that power disappears, unit shuts off. When that power reappears, when you start the car, unit comes on. And you could have it set to replay. So just, that's it. It is literally designed to sit in your car, and when you shut off your car, she goes to sleep or she shuts off. When you turn on your car, she turns back on. That's wonderful. Fucking fantastic. Nothing else does that here. I'm sure some of the other players do it that I haven't put on this table, but I can only fit six on a piece of paper. So we're good with that. This has Bluetooth. This has Bluetooth, and this has Bluetooth. This is Bluetooth because it's an Android device. We know it's going to have it. This has Bluetooth. I don't know how, with a $100 price tag, they got all this shit in here. Because this basically does... This is the end result of many, many years of people saying, hey, could you add this to a player? And here it is. And then, for some reason, this isn't $200. It's $100. It's the one you're all going to buy, all right? We're going to get to the prices of some of them, the quirks. And this one has the least quirks per dollar. That should be a thing that they do in magazines. Let's look at the build. Should eventually get to that. Left side, volume up and down, power or screen on. So screen on, boom, screen off. When the screen is off, the lock, there's three lock settings so that when your screen is off, nothing works. I'm wrong with that too. When the screen is off, now, you could set it so that these buttons are the only ones that function, and this is just on off screen, or next track, last track, and then volume, depending on if you quick tap or hold. Or the other option for lock screen, and this is down here, is these two buttons or three buttons and the pause, which is what I have it set to, or these three buttons and the pause and the next and last track. Could all be set for different ways that the in the menu, which I'm gonna have to get to the menu. Again, we're talking about players here that should be able to be functioned without looking at them in your pocket. You should be able to pause it, unpause it, talk to somebody, next track, raise the volume, all without ever seeing the unit. So phones, you can handle that if you can reach the volume and if you have a button externally, but it's hard, you usually have to pull it out. So that's another one of the benefits. So here we are. The control scheme on this is very iPod 1. Let's go back to an actual list. So you've got these scrolly. It's got a click. It doesn't have a vibration. It's just got a click. But now, I updated the firmware today, and they've added the ability to use the circle to actually just press down to scroll down, or press and hold up to scroll up. So you don't have to scroll, you could just go buh, 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 buh. Okay, let's go enter. It's playing music, that's fine. Back, back, back. Main menu, all right? Your main menu is, there's no touchscreen here, no. God, I'm so confused. Pick, why do you show me volume? Oh, that's right, I forgot. So now we're in the play screen. So now this scroll wheel will bring you to the list and you could just hit next or hit go. But once you're playing, if you have it enabled to do touch buttons, up now is volume, this is volume, and once volume is up, the scroll wheel is volume, and pause. And also, this is next track, because it's literally dedicated next and last track buttons. Or touching the right side is next track. So now you have two. And let me get to the main screen issue that I had, because I was blowing my fucking brains out earlier today. So here's the scroll wheel select, right? You see, it's infinitely scrolling left and right. Or you press it and it'll pick, and it completely changes the style of what it looks like when you do that. Okay, that seems cool. So now I'm scrolling, and what if I hit up and hold it? Well, then it's just going around and around and around without me moving. So if you're scrolling manually and then you stop and just barely let off, it'll just keep going and around and around and around and around and around. Like, what the? Took me a while to figure that out. So you get, it says you up top. So now playing is that. Oh, it's doing it again. Now playing is the first one. So that should, I really do like this player. This is making it seem worse than it is. So there's now playing. I could just shut off those directional buttons. And in fact, let's go do that. So you get now playing, you get categories. You could search, I guess it's via genre. Yeah, you could choose by all songs, album, artist, genre, favorites, playlist, recently added to device. Thank you for that. Recently added to the device, because you get that new music, you put it on here. Oh, what was it again? There it is. It's in that fucking menu. Okay, so next we get browse files, which is just basically your file browser, because I have two folders and just random. It's making a lot of noise for not moving very fast, just saying that. Hit go, great. Initiate volume, and then you could again do that, like just like that, Ken. But at least this goes from like 50 to 100. And it still has, you know, volume at 50, and you can scroll down and down and down. All right, where was I? There's two. Oh, it's doing that thing. There are two settings menus. Play settings and system settings. Play settings, and I have to, hold on a second. I have to make this music stop going. Okay. No, stop going. Okay. It's basically you hit back, and back brings you all the way to the menu, or pass the menu back to what's playing. So you just, it's just a loop. I'm actually okay with that. So play settings. Play mode, shuffle or not shuffle. Resume mode, position. Playback gap, none, or fade in and out. And actually there's the third one here, is long fade. Dot, 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 dot. Whereas remember when I was talking about the Fiio M3 where you hit next and it's like fades in, fade in. This has an unadjustable fade of like 7 seconds or 8 seconds. And it's like this. It's out, 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 in. And it's every song and every time you manually change the tracks, and it's useless. It needs to be just faster. And I just, so that's just a negative. The long fade, if you like gapless playback and fading, this is not gonna work. If that works, this doesn't work. They need to make that adjustable. You could set the max volume again. You could set default volume to either custom or what you left on last. You get a fixed volume setting because this will do a line out. You could set this to a line out. So if you want to power by another amp, you don't want anything fucking with this. The equalizer in this is a much more simple 7-band than the Astle and Kern with a couple presets, rock and, oh, I can't do that. Rock, classical, jazz, pop, dance, vocal, metal, custom, and then off. I'm not a, you know, in my car, I EQ the fuck out of everything. Because it's my car. It's a 97 Corolla or a Caprice that has no auxiliary input. So it's always a 97 Corolla and it doesn't sound very good. So there's our equalizer. We get line out mode, volume adjustable, or fixed. That's for when you line out. The fixed level, you could adjust the actual level of a fixed level. Anything further down, balance left and right. Play through folders, which is a play, you know, at the end. It'll either you could set it to stay in a folder you leave it in, or you could have a jump out and play all your Britney Spears too. And then we're back. So that's the play settings. Now we can go to the system settings. So you get update media library, manual. You get the Bluetooth mode on and off. And Bluetooth mode is currently on, and I was using my 669s with the M-Power adapter, and it was working just fine. There was a couple stutters here and there, and this was in my pocket, which I'm not sure if I want to blame this or that, because I don't really do this very often. But the Bluetooth works. So if you had those Bose Quiet Comforts, you could leave this in your pocket instead of your phone. You're only going to get 10 hours, so you better not be going to Japan, because that's a 12-hour flight. Please don't sleep, screen. Please don't sleep. Bluetooth settings, it literally just, you set it, say, I'm searching for devices, you turn that on, you say pair with it, and it pairs it, and it's done. Very cool. I wish these had Bluetooth, especially someone over there. Key lock settings, and here's where it does the key lock screen, where you can choose either just the side buttons, or the side and pause, or the side and pause and next and last track. So you basically just unlock all the buttons at that point. What the fuck's the difference? So leave that alone, but you need to be able to play and pause the music without looking. And the fact that you could have set this so that that doesn't happen is useless. Screen timeout 30 seconds, you could set the brightness, you could set the idle standby to on, idle standby timer, sleep on off, sleep timer, USB mode, you could set to storage or in vehicle, that's where you set it to in vehicle. USB charge is either on or off, and I'm not 100% don't know, just wouldn't even let me change it. And then there's a couple themes, which are just basic colors. You get gray or pink, or dark gray, pink, light gray, blue, lighter gray than like tan. So no support inline headphone controls. This supports inline headphone controls, like on, I guess the Hifimans over there have it. And I don't have any headphones here to test with that, but, you know, just like your phone will change tracks, last track, pause, answer the phone. This will play track, last track, it won't answer the phone because there's no phone, but it'll handle all that, which is fucking fantastic. Again, another thing that I wish these had. This probably has it. Now that I'm thinking about it, have I tried that? Not sure. File name display is file name. Cover display is normal. Lyrics display is on. Scroll wheel press function, which is that thing that I was talking about. Let's shut that off. So now up, down, left, right won't work. Now I have to scroll through things. Scroll wheel prompt tone. Reset media library. About the X1. Language. Font size, which is set to small because it'll change the font. Barely. It doesn't like double it. Storage formatting. Factory restore. That's a lot of options. So those are the two option settings. Then you just go back and be like, can I just play music, please? Please let me just fucking play music. Please. Please, God. That sounds really good. It doesn't sound Astlin Kern good. And spoiler, it doesn't sound Hifiman or Pleno D. Actually, you know what? I'm not going to say. This is the top of sound quality. But these three are like just below. Just below. This is $50. I don't expect that to really compete, although it sounds better than my phone still. And the M2, which, are we getting to the M2 next? I think we're getting there next. So let's see, I could do next track by just holding it for a second. And now it's next track. If I press it, and press it, and press it, and press it, I'm raising the volume. It works in a pocket. Everything works flawlessly. Except for the occasional scroll wheel fuckery. Line out, it does occasionally a weird wheel, which I figured out. The EQ plus custom. No touch screen, which, take your pick. Is that good or bad? Do you care if there's a touch screen? If there's this many buttons, you don't need a touch screen. If it's a scroll wheel, you don't need a touch screen. Oh, head buttons. We talked about the head buttons. As far as power goes, this got a 7. This got a 8 unbalanced, a 9 balanced, and this gets an 8 unbalanced because it only has unbalanced. We unplug that, she pauses, which means that after she goes idle for a little bit, she'll just shut off. Thank you. Thank you, Fiio, for keeping that in mind. Put you down. There's a blue LED. Garbage. Actually, we'll put you down on top of your place. The Cowon M2. Now, before we get to the M2, where is my... Did I pick it up to clean it and lose it? Oh, I don't want to pause this video. Don't make me pause the video. I suck donkey balls. 1 second. I wouldn't have brought it into the bathroom to clean it. Baby? Baby? Is it in my pants? Is what she always asks. There it is. All right, we took a trip through my house for no reason, but it's always fun. You see this? This is a Cowon D2 Plus. This was my brother's. He gave it to me years ago. It was his for years. And it is the most rock solid piece of hardware I've ever used. Ever. You get into it, you hit that, you close it, the power button's a lock, you hit that, it plays, it's now playing music. Next track, last track, you unlock it, now it's volume. This made me believe in portable music players. It's thick as fuck, plus I have foam on it, so it's adding like, well, not a quarter inch anymore. This foam has been on there for years, but the foam's on there so I could just, you know, drop it. It's fine. Use a full-size SD card. This is severe. This was severe, and this is probably what makes me a shuffler. People were all into the iPod. Remember the iPod? I don't think I've even seen that shit anymore. iPods were for people who need to go to a song and play it. And that was never my needs. I just need to have music I care about and then be able to hit next track and have it just show up. Just next track. Okay, no, next track. Okay, this one's fine. And I kept this in my car, and it's always been in my car, and I took it out just so I could show it in this review, because when I saw the M2, now not to be confused with the Fiio M3, it's the Cowon M2. It is literally the next generation of this. It's just thinner and lighter with a better screen. So let's put this down and let's turn the M2 on. I gotta check for firmware also. 1.05. SD card, it's reading that. The thing you're gonna have to know about the two Cowons is that this load time is irrelevant. And in fact, I mentioned it at the bottom here. I just turned it on. Let's shut it off. Sleep mode, right? It's not off. It's in sleep mode. It'll stay in sleep mode for about a week before the battery gets like to a real drained part. And the benefit of that versus turning it on and off like everything else needs to do, well, not the other Cowon, but is that when it's time to take it out of sleep mode, I gotta hold it for longer. Hold on, wait. And it's up. So wait. Let me just demonstrate it again because that was bad. Sleep mode. All right. It's sleeping. And I want to play music right now. I want to play music. It's playing music. Let's take a look around. 3.5 millimeter. In this little door. This little door that hides your micro SD card slot. And did we talk about the internals of things? The Fiio has none and holds 256 if you wanted to. It's still lit for some reason. The Cowon M2 has a 32 gig internal and can take a 64 gig card according to the site. However, and I say however because however, I've gotten it to work with a 128 if you go through fucking hell on earth. of formatting it with a special program to exFAT versus a thing, and then you can never turn it on while it's in the unit, because this will act as a card reader when you plug it in. But if you do that, it destroys all your work, and you have to go and redo it. So you got to pull that SD card out to plug this into a computer. So if you want to load up to 32 gigs, you can load the 32 gigs, and that's nice and easy. But as soon as you want to load more on that SD card, you got to do it through a card reader. So have a card reader, and you fill that card reader up, and then it'll work with a 128 gig card, and oh my god, it's such a pain in the dick. But it does work. You just have to never plug this into a computer with the bigger card set to exFAT, or it'll just freak out. Magnum PI theme. Oh my fucking Christ loud, hold on. That was full tilt volume, my bad. Of all the things, this has the most bullet points. For a reason. Because this thing is stupid. $150, by the way. I'll get the price out of this one. $50, $100, $150, $2,500. And then the Mega Mini is $250 and the Plano D is $215 currently. I think I paid $250 for it. So $150, what does that get you? 32 internal. It'll hold guaranteed 64 up to 128 if you do dumb shit. Battery life, 24 hours. Battery life, less than 10. Battery life, 10. Battery life on this, 90 hours. Do you know what the battery life was on this when it was new? 90 hours. 90. That's long enough to starve to death. Well, at least die of thirst. All right? That's what you want in a PMP. I want to have a bullet point. You could start playing this and then just not eat or drink and be dead before the battery dies. Sold. That's why I bought this and that. Because guess what the battery life is in the Plano D, and I'll get to it in a second. It's 100 hours. Just in case you last a little extra long, that'll kill you. So, first bullet point on the M2 is does everything. It does everything. What does that mean, Zeus? What do you mean it does everything? It's just a portable player. You think that. Let's go to the menu. Music, videos, pictures, radio, documents, flash, scroll up. Recorder, browser, calculator, settings, notepad, typist, scroll up. Stopwatch, rotate, which just rotates the screen for no fucking, I don't know what the reason is, but now the screen's this way. Rotate, and then you have power, theme, and sleep mode. How do we begin this? I don't know how we begin this. What was my second thing? Good buttons. Let me get to the selling point of this. Of all the players here, all the players I've ever used ever in the entire world on the history of the Earth, this has the best physical buttons of any of them ever, ever. And for $150, as much as I love this, and it's okay, I just talk. Right now, in my hand, my thumb is next track, last track, with play pause there, and my fingertip is on the volume control. And I could hold it like this, and I can control every aspect I need of this player without moving anything. Put the volume up, put the volume down, next track, last track, play pause. It's all here. The screen never has to go on. You just sit. You could just be walking about, what's the song louder? I don't like this song. Hold on, pause, I gotta talk to somebody. Oh, this is why I bought this. Because I knew this had the buttons on top. And I love those three buttons, and I love being on next track, last track, up, flip switch, volume down. I don't have to flip the switch, because it's top and side. It's got the menu button is here, which you don't really need to access unless you're looking at it. But the positive on the volume is the only thing that has a feel other than the play pause, which you're not gonna get confused. So you know where up is. You know that you're not accidentally hitting next and last track, because the play pause has a raised thing. These are smooth, but you're pushing to the end. It's going to be very similar on the Plano D, which has everything on top, which could argue is better, but I'm now controlling it. I'm now controlling the unit. Play. Volume. Next. Pause. Just never moving my hand. Okay. Good buttons, does everything, lacking power. Unfortunately, I gotta take this, before we get into the rest of this insanity, It's only a 7, so it's the same power output as this, but it's cleaner than that. And frankly, powers this fine, powers these fine. It gets just enough with the 600s, just enough, but not enough for this to play like a quiet song. My judgment is a loud song's gonna be fine. It's when you get a well-recorded, like, quiet song with a piano, and then you louder. I need this to be louder so that it doesn't get there. Oh, one other thing about everything here. This is sort of like an overview that I really, it's just be written across the whole fucking thing. None of them at all support replay gain. Replay gain is the tagging functionality that you can do where it'll listen to all your music and it'll say the volume of it, the average volume, the peak volume. And on a computer, like in FUBAR, you could say, okay, take these loud songs and bring them down a little bit, these quiet songs and bring them up, and everything sounds the same. It's just adjusting, it's a volume imprint. It's not actually fucking with the waveform. It's just saying, when this song plays, bring it down 4 decibels. When this song plays, bring it up 2 decibels. And you get like a very mean average. And it's very good for not blowing your brains out. But none of these have that. Even though you can tag a song, and I've seen other players that have it. I don't remember which one. The X-Duo? Did the X-Duo? Something has replay gain reading functionality. And none of these do. Not even that son of a bitch. And that's mildly upsetting. What does it say? Onboard skater. Onboard skirt. I really should label these better. All right. To the menu. So, videos. We'll just start with video. Yeah, I know that one will play. Play another one that will play. Lower that volume a bit. How do I actually get to see it? Hit the picture of a thing. Oh, it's just a list. So this is the Cowon. It comes with videos. What is it doing? Just play one. Will that eventually go away? Here you get this. Oh God, I'm having a seizure. So I'm in videos, right? And it brings you up with this menu. Okay, here, it finally will go away and it'll show me the video, which I can play pause here. It's very Korean. By the way, both koans are made in Korea. The nice Korea, I don't think the Kim Jong-un Korea. This is China. Aslan Kern is Korea, which this is obviously China. The Hifiman is China. So Korea. Korea also makes my bidet, which review either out before or after this, but Korea makes the best stuff for that. Okay, close. Okay. So this is going to be a theme where you go into something and it's like, all right, so you could play, and I won't play my brother's anime music video from 700 years ago, but or you get it open, and open will show you that I have 2 files on there. Or it can go up and you can browse through the unit. But okay, close that. Now we'll go back to playing it. Not that one. I won't play that one. I understand I won't play the AVI. It's got weird. Who cares? You're not going to play videos on it, but I just want to show something off. So you play that. Then you have previous and next buttons down here, which you go previous. You could do a fucking video loop functionality. It's doing video loops, so shut that off. You can bookmark this video, or at least a point in this video. You can capture a screenshot. You can insert the jet effect of... Wait till I get to the jet effects in this. It's just ridiculous. Holy shit. So let's go back over. Play, pause, rewind, open. And the next one is subtitle display, where I could choose 16:9 or 4:3 or the scale of the unit, and then I could adjust brightness. Why? Why is this on? I have apps that I've paid for on my Android phone that don't have that functionality for video playback. Let's go back to hit menu and go. That was one of the like 12 things we're about to discuss, which is why this video is going to be long. And I don't care. It's a Z review. I can make it as long as I want. Average viewing time for my videos, by the way, I looked it up. Under 5 minutes. 4 minutes and 54 seconds. So this hour-long video, no one's going to see it. I don't care. Picture viewer. Let's look at some pictures. And it's got film strips in the corner, which makes no sense because it's a picture viewer. So let's go into a picture, load his picture. Of course, I got some anime bullshit on here. And I have the choice to zoom, to rotate, settings. I could do slideshow, whether it fades in and out or slides or shuffle it. Why? The next thing, oh, the delay is 5 seconds. Okay, that's a lot of options. Again, I have apps on my phone that don't have as many options for showing fucking pictures. So let's go to Zoom, right? So you got a Zoom bar at the bottom here. So I can zoom in and out on a Hitagi. But look at the increment of Zoom that I can do. It is zooming every time I press that button. Oh, this is a resistive touchscreen. Where everything else is just a hard, like your phone is a hard capacitive touchscreen where it detects your finger. This is a physical moving membrane that you have to press down. And that is a big no-no for a lot of people. That's what the original Cowon D2 from many years ago used, where it feels soft and you actually have to press it down. I'm glad I remembered to say that even though it's a bullet point, but I just, and it's beeping, but it's going beep, 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 beep. Can't hear that beep? Hold on a second. You know why you could hear that beep now? Am I up to the part where it has a built-in speaker? There's a built-in speaker right there. Anyway, let's zoom into her and then we'll click that. And honestly, you can't do two-finger drag because again, it's resistive touchscreen. The color accuracy on this piece of shit thing is like flesh tones look. That looks amazing. I don't know if the camera can pick it up, but that's correct for skin tone. Double click, I swipe to the next one. I can, it'll load it. I just can't zoom it. Oh, that one's not good. Can't look at that one. Oh. Honeycomb, there you go. It's much better. Just zoom it in. I don't know why this is on here. Right? I don't know why, not the pictures. I know why those are on here. I don't know why there's a video player and a photo viewer, and we're still getting there. I don't want to navigate. Menu button. That's the escape. That is the most... You could buy this and never put music on it and be entertained for hours. So I've looked at video. I looked at pictures. Let's listen to the radio. What kind of radio? Literally the fucking radio. Now you're hearing static for a reason. The headphone cable acts as the antenna. That's literally the radio playing. Let's go back to the radio app. I'm gonna lower the volume so I could leave it plugged in. So you could drag this 23 presets. What's the previous thing look like? Manual mode, record. This will record the radio. Scan the radio, presets for the radio. Here's the radio and you could dial in whatever you've got. I've got a station currently. I think it's only FM. What region? USA, Korea, Japan, or China, Europe? I could have taken this to Japan and listened to the radio. And then you get to pick sound quality, stereo, or mono, which is what you want on a good tuner. So, fuck me, man. Why? Why do I have a radio on this? And why do I not have a radio on everything now? Because now I'm jealous. Although the radio is usually shit, but it's here. And I can record the radio. Speaking of that, text documents. So here's some Fiio DDR. You can read some text documents. I don't need to know any of this. Let's escape that entirely. It'll play Flash, which I'm not sure how or what, because I've never actually had a Flash file. Well, I've had a few Flash files, but they definitely wouldn't be inappropriate for this. Let's scroll down now. Recorder. So now you get an actual... And hold on. Yeah. Okay, so now the recorder is probably blowing up, but I could hear myself. Previous page here is... the playback device for the recorder, then they go forward, and here's the actual recorder, where I could hit record. Now recording. Now recording. Again, I don't know why this exists. And then let's stop that, saving it. And over here, we could adjust if I want this to be the microphone that's built into the unit, or this headphone jack will become a line-in, and you could record via line-in, and then you could set the quality to 256 is the highest, and the volume is the level input. And why? Again, I don't know. Cowon went fucking nuts. What's a good idea? Do it! There was just a box where they just kept putting things in it. And they just kept doing it over and over and over again. This is going to be the longest one on the video because it has to be. Now, the browser is not a web browser. Thank God. That would be the worst thing ever. Browser is just like a file browser. So I could browse through the M2 and Blue Scholars and I could play it from here. Or I could search with a full fucking keyboard, which we'll get back to that and why that's bad in a second. Calculator. It's got a calculator. I don't know any other portable media players that are just like, I need to know what 9 times 9 is. Times 9. Times 9. Times 9. What will it give me? E. We're up to the trillions, people. Millions, billions, trillions. Oh! It can only do up to the billions, and then it gives me the E. The exponential fucking... Fuck, why? That clear? That X clear? No, it's telling me times. That's clear. It's not scientific. I guess I should write not a scientific calculator. I keep touching the screen. Remember the beginning of this fucking units review where I said it has the best buttons ever? None of this ever came to mind. I'm going to skip settings for now. I'm going to skip past and go to Notepad where you could actually draw. Like, it should be called bitmap. I wrote dick and I wrote the word Zeos. And if we go to, how many pages is this? There's 5 pages. You could hold a total of 30 drawings. So here, let's pick the background. I want polka dots. And then let's pick the pen. And I want a marker. And I want it to be the color brown. And we're going to write... Fuck. And we hit back, and then it's saved. So number 30 is the word fuck. Why? I don't know. Typist, even better. You literally get 60 pages that you can just come in and with a typewriter. And by the way, this is not a very good, it's not an accurate keyboard. I'm pretty sure if I, because it's capacitive touch, it's a resistive touch. So I think a stylus would be like, touch. So you only got T-O-U. C. What is it doing? Capital X, space. That was a B. There's a calibration thing. Two, whatever. Nobody needs this. But I wrote it anyway. Because I have to show off this unit and it's just absurdity. So that was Notepad. Notepad is actually Drawpad. Typist is actually Notepad. Scroll down one more. Rotate I already showed you, which basically just rotates the unit. And I guess if you wanted the headphone jack out, once you adapt to where the buttons are, now on the bottom, there's no reason not to have... I mean, you could actually have the USB in the top, so it could be charging and it could be right side up. Now I gotta wake it up on this side. That's just... Wait, no, that's not it. This is it. I'm completely backwards. So rotate is just... I'm interested in that. That's interesting. You have the power off mode, so you could actually power the unit off, which I'm not going to do. Or you could put it in the sleep mode, which I'm not going to do. Which, I should also mention, the sleep mode I can get into by just holding this down. It'll just go to sleep mode. Power off is something you can only access through this. And when I get to the Pleno D, there is no button to power it off. The themes, I want to touch the themes, but it brings you to this weird screen where it like... shows you lonely night and the time, good dreams, and it's that, and then it's like, what are you even, what is this a thing? Then if you scroll, now all the menus have fucking changed what they look like. Now that's video, music, and I gotta scroll down, and then I gotta go to fucking, there's apps. I'm in apps, and that's not what I want. So I gotta go back to theme, and now it switches, I don't know. Now I gotta go back to the bottom, because we did not hit... stopwatch. Now, unfortunately, I can't get any of these buttons to control stopwatch, but this is a much better, more accurate stopwatch than my phone stopwatch or any physical stopwatch I've ever owned. Resume. You could do separate laps. How many separate laps can we do? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Will it go forever? Holy shit. Stop. And can I scroll up? I can. I need a cat break. I need to, I should have brought the liquor out. I don't want to review this alone. This belongs right here compared to everything else, which is very simple. And even the Aslan Kern is very simple. And this has a lot of options, but it doesn't have a fucking stopwatch. And then, okay, now we're finally done with the apps and the rotation. Let's go to settings. So now you get 2 pages of settings, right? Genefect, display, time, music, and then the second page is video recording and system. So let's go to Genefect. There's six pages. User 1, User 2, User 3, User 4, Normal, BBE, BBE Viva, BBE Viva 2, BBE Mach Base, Mach 3 Bass, BBE MP, BBE Headphone, BBE Headphone 2, Rock, Jazz, Ballad, Pop, Club, Classic, Funk, Hip, Techno, Music, Wide, Reverb Room, Feel the Wind, Mild Shore, Crystal Clear, Reverb Cathedral. Fuck you, is what it should just say. That's too many. The price is too damn high. If they charge a dollar an option, this would be a cheap unit. 150. Holy shit. Remember when I used to play music with this? I remember that. That was fun. Let's go back to that. I don't remember how music play go. Oh, I do find it really cool. So here, we're playing music now, I hope. And it's actually going to play out of the built-in speaker. Not a very good speaker. Every phone's better, but you know what? It's got one. Now. My stomach hurts from this review already. Wake up the screen. There's the album art spinning on a turntable in the background. And if it doesn't have album art, it'll just say don't stop the music or, well, that has album art. Oh, One Punch Man spinning around on my turntable. That is super cool. None of you do that. You're all bad. Do cool things, especially for $2,500. Do cool things. So, okay, we got One Punch Man. Let's lower the volume on that so I could hear myself talk. Here's your just progress bar, by the way, is there. Or you press, and then you could drag the progress bar there. Previously pause, next, open, and open is how you would browse. But first, let's hit the left button. I won't do it. Right button. Again, we could loop playback, so I could hit loop. And I get loop again. Want to drive someone out of their fucking mind? That's how you do it. So back to that. Let's disable the loop. Jet effect. And here we get those same... How many reverb auditorium? No. No. Next. Settings. Repeat or shuffle. Play boundary. Folder one or all. I have it all. Playback speed. Pitch correction on or off. Oh God, I love this. I love this thing, but it's like, I'm gonna die of hunger before I'm finished reviewing it. So. I'm gonna put it in sleep mode. I'm not even, you know what? It's better this way. I'm not going to hold it while I read the rest of these because I'll just keep playing with it. FM, stopwatch, recorder, thank God. Hand feel is the best. It's the best. It's the best design of anything ever. Boom, I control every aspect of it. That's fine. Resistive touchscreen is old school tech, but for some reason I think it works on that. Again, the Plano is not that. The keyboard search. So you saw me pop up a keyboard before when I was typing. You can search your music library with it. Unfortunately, it only searches in the folder you're in. So I tried to go back to the main full overall menu of on inboard and outboard? On internal and external thing. And I wouldn't find it. Like, no, a song I knew was on there. I searched it. It wouldn't find it. Then I went to the folder above that and I wouldn't find it. Then I went into the folder where there's 10 files and I was able to search for it with the keyboard. So if you want to... It's actually going to be easier to use the search functionality on this unit if you strip everything out of folders and just drop it into one massive puddle, because then you could actually use the search keyboard, which is interesting. Fast power on retouch. So I think I've covered that, and this had to be a 20-minute review just inside this hour and 20-minute review. It's just ridiculous. I gotta get away from Cowon for a second. Let's go to the Hifiman. You've seen this in my videos. I pull it out all the time. I use it all the time, and I don't know why I use it. Because when I sat here to do the list, it's got so many issues. So many issues. Onboard memory, zero. External memory claims 256 it'll hold. Okay. Want to look at it? Power, nothing. Volume, headphone out, micro SD, mini. Return, left, right, enter is what I'm going to call that as enter key. Let's turn it on. Let's turn it on again. A little bit longer hold there. Oh, God. It's like starting a carburetor. Okay, a little bit longer hold now. Hifiman Mega Mini. Now, when Hifiman sent me this, I assumed the price was $100. Because I took it out. I'm like, oh, this is pretty nice, man. Oh, this is pretty nice. I didn't look it up. I didn't look. It wasn't even for sale yet. It wasn't even for sale. Like, here, I had it before it was for sale. And I've been sitting on it. And now it's for sale. And it's $250. And I'm like, what? So, 256. Battery life on this, 15 hours. Remember, I want you to remember, 24, less than 10, 10, 90, 15, and the left pleno is 100. So 15-hour battery life. Okay, it's a little unit. This is a little unit, too. This is okay, okay. My level for power is 7, which is the same as the Cowon M2 there. Are you ready for the tour of the unit? Let's hit back. Here's the main home screen. There's no up and down. It's just left and right. So you get used. You actually get used to it real fast. So you get now playing, which is that. You get return again. You get file explorer, which is literally DCIM, MISC, music. You go in here, you can hit a match, plug my headphones in. There's no external speaker in this, so I have to listen. I want the Amanchu soundtrack, which, by the way, go at least listen to that, because it's amazing. The volume is reset to 10, and I think it does every time it shuts off. Nice and clear. Back, back, back. Back. Remember, this is the home screen. What you're looking at here is the home screen. So now playing, file explorer, artist, album, genre. Next screen, favorites, all songs, settings. Settings, system version, repeat, shuffle, backlight, auto power off, screen lock switch, language, database update, reset, format. No, no, no. That's it. That's it. I wrote the word simple, and then I put four dots after it. There's no EQ. There's no touchscreen. The lock is useless. There are no options. It won't auto stop. The volume is exponential, but the sound quality is superb. It's probably, I want to say it's better than the Pleno D and the M2 and just under this. But I don't have the mechanical ears required to state that fully. This is the slow kid in class. He's very pretty. He's very thin. He's going to be a model someday. But he's just, there's no background art. And I they've been emailing like firmware updates since I got this. And I think I've installed them all. But it's like, okay, artist. Okay, a perfect circle. Okay, this album, go. And then it plays, and you could hear it. Now my volume, okay, this is just the volume. It actually works. Like 20 is like, okay, low, and then you can put it up, and 32 is the loudest, and these are efficient as fuck headphones. It's fine. It's showing me track, if I hit next track, what does it do? Yeah, it'll repeat the same track because I've navigated to a folder. There's only one track in that folder. It's gonna repeat this track. If I wanted to do all my music, I gotta go back, 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 and I gotta go to not artists, not albums, not genre. I gotta scroll down to all songs, and then once I'm in all songs, if I hit okay on the Neon Demon soundtrack, now next track will play shuffle. I have it on shuffle, repeat all, and now it'll just skip around. God, this sounds good. Put the volume up. If there was album art, there'd be album art. There's no album art. It says it's FLAC. It says the kilobits per second. There's the thing. Can I fast forward? I can fast forward with this. Next track. Okay, simplicity is good. It's $250. I've shut off the screen right now. Screen is now off. Right? Hit that button. I want to change tracks. Okay. I want to make this a little bit quieter or louder. Okay. I want to pause it. Okay. Every time you want to apply any function to this, the button press wakes the screen up, then you can do it. Blow my fucking brains out. Yet I still use it. You've seen me use it in videos. You've seen me take it out because it sounds so good and it is so simple. It turns on, you hit play, it plays music, and then that's it. That's what I do with it. That's its functionality. But for the cost, this is the most expensive unit on the table other than the Aslan Kern, which costs 10 times as much. And yet I still use it. And I'm not sure if it's the shape or the... It sounds so good. And I want to put it above the Cowons, but I have a bias. And I'm human. You tell, if someone tells you they have no bias for anything ever, they're not human. You should probably stop the robot apocalypse by murdering them. Or by dismantling them or destroying them. I want the Cowons to destroy everything in the world. Because I've had Cowon for years and I love it. And then this one comes out and it's like, what the fuck is wrong with you? And I'm going to talk about this one and you're going to hear my bias come up. But I keep looking at this Hifiman, which is too much money. It's just sitting here. It's sitting here on the goddamn list with... Wow, that got really messed up. Fiio X1, M2, Pleno D is a price order, by the way. $250. Only two reviews, 3.5 stars. So... There's a bigger one. There's a Super Mini. This is the Mega Mini. The Super Mini's $400. And if the $400 one of these sounded as good and actually fixed all the problems I'm talking about, it'd be worth $400. Screen wake. Problem. It's too simple. Can something really... Let me pause that music. Hold on. Oh, God. It's not a huge deal. It's just a deal. It is a fucking deal. Simple. Can it be too simple? Considering there's no EQ, no gapless playback, no fader, no blue... This cost 2.5 times as much as this. It doesn't sound 2.5 times better. It sounds better. But this does everything that you could ever possibly want. Or this for $50 more. You can draw the word... You could draw a dick and then draw another word with it and then type your dissertation and do calculate. Not because you need to, but you can. And this one just comes out and does absolutely nothing but play music. And I think I respect it for that. The useless lock. Oh, I was talking about useless lock. So, you know when you shut the thing off, you could enable that to also lock the unit, which then doesn't allow you just to wake up the unit with any button press, which means you have to unlock the unit to fucking... Why? Okay. Won't auto stop. Oh, that's another fucking wonderful thing. So, it's playing, right? It's playing. Still playing. It's still playing. Let's put this down. And in 15 hours, that's dead. Which, you know, in 15 hours is that's tomorrow when you pick it up to try to use it. That's happened more to me than ever on anything. It just doesn't detect you unplugging it. The volume is exponential. And this headphone's not showing it off as well as, like... Well, fuck, let's take these monsters out. The longest ear you've ever... You'll all be proud you made it this far. 32 is the maximum. 30 is 30% quieter. 31 is 20% quieter than that. So from 30 to 32 is a 50% increase of volume. It's like, And then it gets smaller and smaller and smaller. And 20 is basically should be the lowest it should ever go on anything ever. God, these headphones sound good. And this player sounds good. Yeah, Hifiman sent it to me. I'm basically shitting all over it, hoping that they will fix all the issues, or send me the other one if it does other things, because I can't. It's only a power 7. Same as this. Same as this. This whole row. Let me just unplug this. I don't even need to talk about it. Literally, this does... This shut off. When you go to shut it off, you can't just hold the power either. You've got to hit the button, let it wake up, then hold the button to shut it off, and then it shuts off. And God, I like how thin it is, and I love the way it feels, and it's simple, and it's like, but I can't. Not for that. For $100, I'd have a hard time, real fucking hard, selling it over the X1. Real fucking hard. Because this just does so much more. And yes, this sounds better and has a little bit more battery life, but 250. You ain't that famous yet, Hifiman. You ain't there yet. The Pleno D. Look at it. I think Cowon have stated that they hired a French designer or something to design their units. And you know what? It fucking shows. It's just a box. It's just a box. How do you make a box pretty? I don't know. Every cell phone on Earth looks like absolute garbage. At least mine has like a curve. I was able to get wood, pretties it up a little bit. So how do you make a box pretty? Well, let's turn it on. Do you get that perfectly flat glass capacitive screen that actually works? Which doesn't want to play because there was no headphones plugged in, but it'll play when I force it to. This side, micro SD card, micro USB. You get all 5 buttons, which we'll get back to. And on the top, you get this machined piece that has a lowered section for the power button. Did you see it blink, by the way? So you got a round thing, a blinking white LED to indicate on. When you plug it in, and I know this is a thing, you plug that in, that now glows red, and when it's fully charged, it glows green, and it's just a database update, because I plugged it in. Oh God, did I just break it? Remember that thing I talked about? I may have just broken this. Turning it on again. Please just work. I'm not editing anything. Yeah, please do a database update and figure it out. We'll talk about the build some more. So you get this machined aluminum, serial number, 32 gig, LED ring with the push button that is just, it's just up enough. It's fucking just pretty. Here's the back. The back says Pleno. It's got the machined aluminum with the stripes on it. Does it still say 6,000 tracks? Are any of them going to work? It does, thank God. Okay. I've used this, of all these, and I bought these two at the exact same time. This has been used a total of 6 hours. This has been used like 600 hours. And this has all those funky. That's fancy and funky features, by the way. Funky, hashtag funky. Features, but this just is better. First bullet point. All right, cool. 32 gig internal. So it comes with 32 gig. I think it came with 16 or 32. I was getting the 32. This comes in either silver or gold. The gold costs like $8 more, and frankly, I'm not a huge fan of things that are gold. So fuck that. Save my $8. 100-hour battery life. This has a 90, this has a 100, all these can go to hell. As far as I'm concerned, I want to be able to take my player, plug it in, go somewhere, shut it off, or in this case, sleep mode it, pick it up the next day, go somewhere. My phone is already a big enough baby that's like, charge me, I've been running for 5 hours. Granted, my phone is getting old, but you have to charge your phone. And I did not want that responsibility on my portable media player, which, all of these, even if you use it for 3 hours, you've taken 30, 40% of the battery life away. Except for this one, which is ironic because it's pretty good. I never have to charge this. I've gone weeks taking this up, using my car, driving back, And it's just, I just never charge it. Just never have to. I see the battery gets low. I'm like, wow, must have been fucking a month since I've charged it. And then I charge it. 100-hour battery life. This is more powerful than the Cowon M2. These are all 7s as far as power goes, and this is an 8. Nothing really, nothing in this pile beats like a Hot 2 as far as being able to power something. Or the X2O, XD05. Those are just monsters. And even though this should be a monster, the battery life would be even worse. And it's already at negative 10, less than 10 hours. So the fact that this will do 100 hours of playback, and I've tested that. I plug some headphones in. I put enough music on it for it to play. I sit it in a box because you just hear headphones playing all the time. And I came back 3 days later. 3 days! This is like a Jewish story about the candles. I came back 3 days later, and sure enough, the bar was like a 25%. I'm like, I'm never going to see when it dies, so I'm just going to charge it again. And I picked it up, and I that's like miracle. Fucking miracle. How do you make headphones go for 3 full days plus and just not die? How you do with this size? If this was an entire battery and it plugged into something like this size, maybe I'd believe 3 days. But it isn't. It's just ridiculous. Cool LED, which I went over. It blinks white, which looks super cool when there's no like lights on. Or it'll show green, or it'll show red. Fast power on, so it'll do the same deal as... So here's... I'm playing something. Hit the button. Sleep mode. Again, show sleep mode for like a week. Just a week. After a week, I'd definitely turn it on charger because it uses like 5-6% a day. And I've had it so where I've let it sleep for a little bit longer than that, and I turn it on, it doesn't have much left in it. But, ready? I'm going to... Actually, I could do this with the music. Give me something loud and open. Was it like 1.5 seconds? Sorry. We're going to get to that bullet point soon. I said battery life forever. So it's playing music. I shut it off, sleep mode. I'll put my finger on the play button, and I'm going to wake this up and play as fast as possible, and go. You cannot access music faster than that. Just to, like, now play music. Now play music, now. Now play music. Button feel. It isn't... It's still one of these. You hold it, you get the wire come down. You don't need to access this, because that's just to turn the screen on. You get... This one is smooth. This is next track, last track. It has no raised part of it. And you know that next track is the further one, so you just press that. Play pause has a raised little indicator so you could feel it. Next, play pause. Then volume is smooth on negative and raised on positive. So you know exactly, even in the dark, you can't tell which orientation it is. You feel it. Oh, I feel the positive. No matter which side it is, you feel, you know where up volume is. Pause, Evangelion. So, I mean, this works. It's just a little bit more sliding to do everything. And I can't go over how important button feel is in your pocket in the dark. I want to hear the next track. Or I want to play pause or someone's talking to me. And this is good. It's not as good as the M2, which has it on both sides. But, you know... These are the things. This, by the way, these are both being sold at the same time. So I thought this was going to be the replacement for this. But no menu, volume reset. Okay. There is no main menu. Whereas this, you can go to a main menu. This, you can go to a main menu. Does that have a main menu? Come to think of it now. I'm trying to think. This has a menu where you get to basic. This has the playback screen, and then you can bring down options. There is no menu. This is dedication to just, you're playing music now. You can go to a list of songs themselves, albums. That's songs themselves. That's artists, albums, the actual song list, which you're going to understand why it's 100-hour battery life when you go to scroll. Let's look at the, can you see this? Look at that stutter. It's not stuttering as much as it is just not rendering every frame. The refresh rate on this has got to be like 15 hertz. But because there's a processor in here that's absolute, I don't want to say garbage, super efficient, it'll last 100 hours. So you just find where you want to go and you hit play and then it plays. Mr. Robot. You can press the album art and it'll take you to a different screen where the album art is bigger. And it shows you that the track one of 6710. You can hit that. It'll show you the information about the track. VBR, blah, 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 blah. Hit back. She picks you back to this. You can next track. You could fast forward with your... There's the bar here. Here's the album art, which is absolute shit. This button gives you access to the list. By the way, that last one is genres. Then you can hit the play. And then this pull down is everything else. So you get loop or stop, shuffle or don't shuffle, all one track folder. You get to add to the star here is to add to a playlist, which you get 10 playlists. I'm sure you could add more than that. You can A-B again, which I don't know what Cowon's obsession is with A-Bing videos and music and everything else. You get it falling asleep as I have it set real fast. The EQ, which, you remember the M2? So you get users 1, 2, 3, 4, which you can go in, and I have them set already. But user 1 is, you got a 5-band EQ, but you could set each band, I think it does 12. Yeah, 12 decibels. I'm assuming that's decibels, by the way, not just some arbitrary number. Then at the bottom, oh God, you could set it to normal, wide, or narrow. So you don't just get points, you could then adjust how the curve flattens out. So this one is set for my Corolla, where it's, I think that was set to normal. Can I pause that? I can. Normal, narrow, wide, and then normal, wide, and it's just all, so there's an EQ in there. It doesn't fit all on one screen for some reason. It would be nice if they could. And then you get BBE, which is bass effects, which I have the BBE up to 3, the Mach 3 bass off, 3D surround plus 2, MP enhance, I'm not sure what it is, but it does make everything sound a little bit crisper. And then my fucking car, who cares? Special effects, reverb, on, off, mode, hall, auditorium, cathedral, canyon, long, blah, blah, blah. So you're never going to run those. Who the hell would run those ever? Not me. Put this back to normal before I blow something up. You get this, which is the album list. And the album list... Did I show you the album list in this? I'm pretty sure I did. It's useless. It's just because... Unless you have every... Because now it's showing me... blanks. And like, what's the blank one? The blank one is just whatever is in there. I have nothing by... Whitney Houston. So, unless you have an obsessive thing where you have every album cover and you know them by heart and you want to search by this and look at how slow it is. It's just so slow. The processor is so slow. So you can play it from this mode. It's a different mode you can look at it from. I'm going to get the hell out of there because I don't... If you don't have an album art, it will just... Oh God, it's stuck now. It's stuck because I went into album mode. Let me go back to the list. Go back to songs, which is that one. That's albums. Songs. As soon as you play something from the songs thing, then you have 6,000 songs to choose from. Okay. Back to this. Remaining time display, track skip interval, 10 second skip interval, A-type skin or B-type skin. It's basically just light colored, dark colored, settings. Jet Effect 5, which we just saw, which is the EQ basically. The display, English, system font, auto display, brightness. Time, you could set the time on the, is it actually 9:10? No, it's 8:10. I gotta set the hours. Hours, I want to set it to 24. Can I set this down? Do I have to go the entire hour? Why am I going up then? This has to go faster than this. This would be ridiculous. Oh, it didn't jump that. So maybe I got to do AM. I don't know. There you go. 8. 10. Wait, what time was it? 8:27. Fuck. Sorry for taking up your precious time while I set the time on my player. That doesn't really matter. All right, then we have, what's that? auto off, sleep timer, calendar. Apparently it's July 6, 2015. Fuck, I wish it was July 6, 2015. I would know so much. I could bet on the election. Let's try the, let's do the year first. It's definitely 2017. And it is January. And you're going to figure out when I do this video now. On the day of the 11th. And the whole fucking thing just explodes. Okay, so now I've set the date. Music. Skip interval, seek interval, and resume is on. System. Button lock. Lock or unlocked, which I want to have those buttons not unlocked. I want to have those buttons always unlocked. Why would I ever do that? Sleep mode on. That means when I sleep it, it won't shut off. You can set it to shut off, but it's an option. Audio left and right is off, which is actually balance. So instead of saying balance, it's audio left and right, and it's off, which means zero. So that's just a weird thing. LED on, yes. Database update, you set it to yes, and then it will just scan. It's just like, yes. Low defaults and information on the actual unit. Free space, 1%. Nice. I like to see that. And guess what? That is the end of the settings. Go back to the play screen, which is the only screen. There is no menu. You're always playing music with this. If there's no music on this, there's nothing else to do. So this sounds probably... fight. This is perfect music for deciding. We've just taken a trip, you and me. This is basically a movie. Zero Views the movie has just ended. I don't think I've helped any of you. Well, if you've been staring at my wallpaper, I've helped some of you do something else. But I don't think I've helped any of you decide on a media player, except for the fact that this is $100. Does just about everything you'd ever need, including things you don't, and Bluetooth, and... This is the winner. The X1 is the winner because it costs $100, and if you're gonna buy a media player, unless you're very severe, and I'm not talking about this severe, this I can't recommend this to anyone. There's no one who needs this. I told Bill not to buy it. Bill bought it anyway. He's gonna be very happy running his HE1000s off a balanced connection on this for 9 hours at a time. This, yes, I think literally children, my nieces and nephews should have all got $50. Actually, are they nieces and nephews? No, they're cousins. I don't have a niece and nephews yet. Thank God. $50 little things, you can load it up with music that doesn't suck and prevent them from ever loading on their bullshit. All modern music is bullshit. Sorry, kids, I'm old now. All your music's bullshit. I can accept this. It shuts off. It's got decent battery life. 24-hour battery life. So it's 100, 90, 24, 15, 10, less than 10. That's good. If you lose it, it's $50. Who cares? Leave that in your car. This is a no. I mean, you'd have to have a real full bank account to worry about this. This is a yes for children's or my first thing. I mean, you could use it. If you go jogging and you just want something super light, just fucking super light, that you don't care if it falls, that's the one. I lost a marker now. It's the worst thing ever in my whole life. The X1 is the mainstay, and I'm going to play with the X5, and that's going to get its own dedicated review because it's not here, and I can't fit 7 on this paper, so it would have probably gotten its own review anyway, or I would have bumped off the M3. This is probably the one you're all buying. Then you get... See, that's the thing. Then you... Ooh. Okay, then that happens. No editing, zero views. Then the Cowon M2 comes on for $50 more. Now, this will hold 256. This has 32 and can hold 64 or 128 if you fucking fuck with it. But I think it might... It doesn't... See, this has got more power. This has less power. This has all those weird things happening inside of it, though. And a little built-in speaker. And you could draw a dick. And it's got a recorder. And AM/FM. And it's... exactly the same thickness, but smaller in form factor. So that's an extra inch bigger. And I want to recommend this so bad. Because it sounds good and I like it. It's just that, do you need It's a resistive touchscreen. That's actually like a resistive touchscreen. It's like, that's $50 more than this. This is still winning, but I'm going to say buy this because I'm biased towards Cowon. And now we've got the Hifiman Mega Mini, which they sent. If I bought this for $250, I'd be upset. If I bought it for $100, I wouldn't be as upset because it sounds. I've taken this out more. This one stays, you know, in my car when I do other things outside. But when I'm in the house here and I'm like, I need some portable player to test, this is the one that comes out. It's always this one. And I don't know why it's always this one, but it always is this one. I just turn it on, I hit play, and I leave it alone, then I charge it. And it does all my shit. It's just way too costly for what it is. For what it is, it does not... It just doesn't. And then the Pleno D, which I just finished, which is just, if aliens came down and they're like, hey, what's a portable media player? What are you guys looking for in it? I'm like, this, want it to look like that and have this functionality. And I want it to be dedicated. This is dedication. No menus, just play screen. Have I made that perfectly clear? God, I hope so. Oh. The Aslan current owner also bought the adapter to go from a 2.5mm 4-pole to a 3.5mm 4-pole. And his is also the adapter. And look, it comes with a case. I think it's leather. Somewhere. Yeah, look, you can slide that in there. Oh, yeah. Now it's worth $2,500. Still not. Still not. I can't wrap my head around it. Aslan Kern, you know, they've just cornered the market on ridiculously expensive music players that, again, this sounds the best out of all of them. You know, handily. But I can't bring myself to tell people to buy it. I can't bring myself to tell you guys to buy it. I can't. That's why the X... If I was going purely on sound quality and prices didn't matter, okay, then buy this one. But it's annoying. And, you know, the volume thing is annoying. This is much less annoying. The thing, okay, and this is the sound quality is just superb. It's too much fucking money still. This is too much money at $250. $2,500 is just like, kill yourself. Because it would be cheaper to have a funeral than to buy that in some places. Actually, funerals are real expensive. I obviously, it doesn't matter how long this video goes because it's gone on, and I've actually had the GoPro hooked up to an external power supply because I knew exactly how long this review would take. Hopefully, the X5 is showing up, and that's $300. Where is it? I love you, go on. Yeah, the X5, second gen, is $300. And that has balanced out like this does. And it's going to have Bluetooth. And it's going to do... DSD 64. So once that's in my possession and I review it, then I don't have to even consider this. And hopefully, well, the form factor of this is still what makes it so nice. It's so thin. But yeah, we could knock this off the table as soon as the X5 is even in range because it claims so much shit. Hopefully it can deliver on it. And that was the portable media player review C-movie that I'm starving. I'm going to go eat now. I really do like this cable. Waifu download in the description. Links to all these in the description. Patreon link in the corner.